This is the SAP Developer News for the 17th of October, 2024.
Hello, developers. September 2024 release of CAP is now available. The first update is about analytics for Capaia. Matomo is used to collect anonymized usage data for Capaia, and users will have the option to disable the tracking. Coming to the Node.js updates, you can now import type definitions generated by the CDS typer on the top-level code, even in the test code. Now we have richer JavaScript and TypeScript snippets in the Capaia, which can now carry type information, allowing you to get a better insight into the APIs used there. Instance-based restrictions for bound actions and functions are now also enforced. SAP Cloud Application Event Hub is the new default offering for messaging in SAP Business Technology Platform. Integrating with SAP Cloud Application Event Hub is provided via CDS plugin at the rate CAP.js event broker. Moving on to Java updates, we have enhancement to the code generator where we now have stricter setters in the accessor interfaces. Accessor interfaces now offer the new factory method to access the data in the given map. Monitoring health status of MTX sidecar is enabled with a new health indicator model provider. Parameter aliases in OData V4 for the entity key values and function parameter values are now also supported. You can easily add handler stubs using add handler CLI command in Java. A new CDS property, UI5.version, allows you to configure UI5 versions used by the Fiori preview. Finally, in the tools update, we have got beta release to visualize deployment descriptor mta.jaml file. This helps you to get a graphical overview of your microservices architecture and the interplay between the application and the services. This also works as a visual linter. There are two new experimental CDS lint checks, now for SQL null comparison and no Java keywords. For more details, please check the links provided in the description.
Hi everyone, and welcome to the SAP Developer News. The SAP Fiori Innovation Day will happen on November 19th in Heidelberg, Germany, in the SAP App House. Interestingly, the same location we were at for SAP Tech at Virtual a couple of weeks ago. The SAP Fiori Innovation Day is open for everyone, and it will be a packed day with content about the SAP Fiori design system, SAP Fiori elements, AI, of course, and it will also contain partner sessions. There will also be a hands-on session about the SAP Fiori Elements flexible programming model. Check out the link in the description for more information and to register. See you. Bye.
Hola, SAP developers. I have some exciting news to share with you today. The message status overview that we are so used to in SAP PIPO is now available in SAP Integration Suite. The message status overview page provides a customizable overview of the messages process and their statuses in a selected timeframe, as well as quick navigation to and from the message monitoring in your tenant. Also, there is a new adapter available to us in cloud integration. This is the SMB adapter, which will allow you to connect to a server using the SMB protocol, meaning that we can interact with an SMB server and read and write files. This is especially relevant for those on-premises integration scenarios. And finally, there is now an alternative solution in cloud integration to the message transform beam adapter module that we often use in SAP PIPO to aid with the transformation of the message during the runtime. It is in the form of Groovy scripts, which support most of the features that existed on the MTB module. Make sure to check it out. Ciao.
If you're in or can get to the Brussels Mechelen area of Belgium in early November, then there's a tech day happening on the latest SAP tools and technologies. Flexso Tech Day 2024 is happening on Thursday, the 7th of November. And following the welcome and keynote, there are sessions across three separate tracks: analytics and integration, extensions, and there's also a trending track. Now, the full agenda is online. The day is open to everyone, but spaces are limited. So head on over to the website to register. And at the end of the day, there's going to be a beer tasting, mostly because the day is being held in a brewery. What's not to like? I'll be there. See you there too.
Hi everyone, and welcome to the SAP Developer News. We're just wrapping up week 3 of Devtoberfest, which means there's just 1 week left for Devtoberfest 2024. So next week we'll have 5 more days of packed content all about SAP development. So on Monday, it will be ABAP and CAP again. On Tuesday, Tooling Tuesday, we'll talk about the SAP Build family. Wednesday is Integration Day. On Thursday, we talk about MAD, which is Machine Learning, AI, and Data. And Friday will be Front End Friday as well as Fun Friday. And for Fun Friday next week, there will be Spooktoberfest, so expect a spooky day. Overall, next week, I counted 24 sessions scheduled. That's a lot of content, and it's great content too. So we hope to see many more familiar faces as well as new faces. Welcome if you're new to this channel. Now's your chance to earn points in the Devtoberfest game board and to progress towards Nerdmana, which would qualify you for the Devtoberfest grand prize. So hope to see you around and see you next time. Bye.